Hey everybody, Robert Wright here, and I'm a private label attorney who helps Amazon sellers protect their brand on Amazon. And today I want to answer the question, do I really need to register my trademark overseas if I'm selling there? So in my experience, one of the best models to grow and scale your Amazon business is to start, if you're here in the States, start on Amazon.com, right? And then as you want to move into different markets, Amazon.co.uk, .de, .france, .spain, .italy, expanding into Europe can really grow and scale your business quite quickly, right? In my own experience doing private label sales, about 30% of my revenue easily comes from Europe, right? And so when you gain a foothold here in the States, it absolutely makes sense to expand to Europe. There's a number of great courses out there that'll teach you how to do it. But then the question becomes, do you need to register your trademark in Europe, right? So let's assume for the purposes of our discussion, you've registered a mark in the States, you've secured brand registry, you've done everything that you need to do to protect your brand on Amazon.com. Now you're moving into a different country. Well, I will tell you this, brand registry still applies. It can be that you're able to leverage your US brand registry and port that over to the UK and to the other European marketplaces. And that's great, but remember, that's on platform. And the rights the brand registry gives you is on platform. So you're protected on Amazon, but that doesn't stop people from going outside of Amazon and infringing on your trademark. So here's the deal. You know, the short answer is this. If you want to make sure that your rights protected are protected in a certain country, you need to make sure that you register there. So if you've registered in the States, you've moved over to .co.uk, make sure you register in the United Kingdom, okay? A lot of different ways that you can do that. You can use something called the Madrid Protocol. It's basically an international framework that will take your US application and port it over to the UK. Really great, really simple, can be decently cost effective, so certainly look into the Madrid Protocol. That said, there are some reasons why you may want to file separately, independently in the United Kingdom, right? If you leverage Madrid, if anything ever happens to your US registration, guess what? It's a domino effect. That whatever has happened is going to undo everything that you've done in the UK, in Germany, in France, in Spain, in Italy. You may not want that, right? So you may want to register independently. Now on the flip side, the more registrations you have, the more it's administrative burden. So you've got to make sure that you're filing, you know, maintaining filing deadlines in the States, in the UK, in France, in Germany, Spain, Italy. So it can really become a little bit cumbersome, and it's definitely not something that you should, you know, go into lightly. But I am telling you, if you want to grow and expand your business, you want to move into Europe, which you absolutely should. Again, easily 30% of your sales are going to come from Europe. Make sure you protect your brand there. Make sure you register trademark. The simple rule is this, register in the countries where you sell and where you care about those sales, okay? Follow that guidance, you're gonna be in good stead, and your Amazon brand is gonna be protected.